Hello, this is Austin Henry 2, Foxtrot Tango Golf, and today we are building the 40 meter 10 minute transmitter. I saw it on DX Explorer's channel and it was interesting, so I'm building my own. I'm also gonna later swap out this 40 meter crystal for this small 20 meter one and see if it oscillates and what the power output is up there, and most importantly, what the harmonics are, because my spectrum analyzer here only goes up to, well, down to, in this case, down to 10 megahertz. So this is the schematic. The design was adapted to the Sunrise Net Special by Walter Kilo Alpha 4, Kilo X-ray X-ray, but I first saw it on the DX Explorer's channel. So the whole schematic is this. We have a transistor, in this case a 2N2219A. Two caps in series with it. It's just, you just key the power to it. We have a 10 nanofarad cap here to avoid some, well, reduce the key clicks. We have an RFC here so that the RF power goes out and not into the power supply decoupling. We have a crystal, a 22 kilo ohm resistor for biasing it, and a second 10 nanofarad cap for some light decoupling. So let's see if it takes us 10 minutes to build this one. I'm recycling a small board from our previous project, so we're gonna use it. Because we are not doing this in any particular way, we are just gonna start by soldering in the antenna connector and work out from it. As is usual for ham projects, especially my ham projects, the RFC is a Siemens unit, a salvaged one. The trimmer cap is salvage, the 220 picofarad cap is salvage, and so on. Damn, this tip is actually garbage. One moment. A tip swapped to something that actually works. So don't buy a T12 BCF3 from AliExpress, I guess. So who knew that the cheapest garbage money could buy was cheap garbage? So anyway, I was planning on starting there, but actually I'm gonna tack down this connector I'm gonna use for the CV key. There we go. So we have a key here, and across the key we had 10 nanofarads. Well, this is gonna look interesting now, isn't it? Thinking ahead about the layout sometimes helps. Okay, so this goes to the collector. Sorry, emitter. So there. So this one goes there, so we're gonna throw in our crystal at this point. Interface. Collector. I'm using a 7.200 megahertz crystal. It's right at the upper bandage, so I'm not gonna connect it to any antenna. I'm just gonna run it into a dummy load and listen with a communications receiver for testing. Because the Finnish 40 meter band stops at that, so this is right at the bandage. But this is a bit of a rock crusher of a circuit. It's not as bad as something with a single tube pulling like multiple watts from it, but it's still not the most gentle circuit for the crystal. So in case I kill the crystal, I don't want to kill my good 40 meter QRPQ crystals, but instead of one of these random bulk ones. So it's better this way. Okay, let's add the base resistor also. So there. And this base resistor goes on the upper side of the RFC, which we can connect here. Okay, there's nothing else connected to the base. Yep. Let's snip that out. And the RFC, yeah, it barely is long enough for the resistor. Well, the resistor is barely long enough. Picofarad one in series here. There we go. I also want one from here to ground, so it's gonna be the one that keeps that off the ground. We'll install it last. Okay. Well, because the trimmer cap is floating here, we can't put the rotor on ground on any point, so it's gonna float anyway. This feels really dumb. But it worked. There we go. I can also tap that with the scope if I'm looking at the output waveform. So this goes there and then it goes out. And this bit here is left as is. Because I soldered my RFC. There? Nope. And I soldered the crystal into the wrong place. I want that one to go to ground. The crystal goes here. Yeah, what a complete mess. I can understand why DX Explorer actually built a circuit board for this one instead of doing it rat's nest style like I'm doing. Oh well. This one goes to that one. Yeah, this looks really stupid, but let's keep going. this would go here. Yeah, let's do it like that. Why not? And time. This was pretty close to 10 minutes. We have the transistor, DC input, key input, RF output. Let's connect it to a dummy load and see what we and a power meter and see what we get. My power meter here, but I noticed that I forgot the last 10 nanofarad one, so let's put that also in there. In this beautiful low impedance installation. There we go, now it should have all the parts. Okay, so now it's magically fixed. I have my communications receiver here, we have a key here, and we can see it starts up and changes the oscillation mode when you touch the crystal. So let's actually remove the antenna if you can still hear it. Okay, then you can see it, there's barely anything on the ammeter, and then we press the crystal and it goes to full power. I guess it needs a bit more capacitance towards ground. Let's actually... And now it latches to transmit. Let's put it closer to the ground. Annoying. I wonder if I solder it to the ground plane, will it then start reliably? Actually, let's look how that, how's that on a scope. Okay, so when we key it up, it's a bit of a random power, depending on the frequency, but we on into a 50 ohm load, we have 225 millivolts, which is not much. So I had my probe set at 1x, and the probe on the probing the circuit to 10x, so now we get a bit more. I also changed the dummy load to this tiny 50 ohm terminator, which gets really hot, so there should be at least like half a watt or so power or something, because on keying up, it takes like 150 milliamps of 12 volts. And that's for something like this, especially because the heatsink does heat up, I'd expect something more than just like 18 dBm out from it, which is less than 20 milliwatts, and that just does not track with this. So this is of course not the ideal RF probing situation, and this probe is like the cheapest garbage I was able to find on eBay, but still, it's only 2.1 volts over 50 ohms. Bit up more spectrum analyzer, so 10 megahertz is somewhere here. So we have 10 here, so 7 is somewhere here, so we only see the harmonics. The span ends at 85 megahertz, so when we key up, we can see that there's quite a bit of harmonics, The first one is minus 6 dBm, so it's not that strong, but yeah, if the scope is to be believed, the output is around 20 milliwatts or plus 20 dBm. Actually, no, that's not 20 milliwatts, that's 200 milliwatts. A bit below. Okay, well, that's a more realistic power output. Still really bad efficiency. We push in like a watt and get 1/5 out. And something like this should be more efficient than that. Oh, yeah. I don't know. I might rebuild a version of this on a piece of like perf board or something else, which is a bit better thought out than this one. But hey, it does work, it's just not that good. You can also FSK key it if you want. So yeah, this definitely needs more work and requires a much better layout. But there it is, it has a genuine Motorola 2 and 2219A. So 200 milliwatts with 12 volts input from a transmitter built in 10 minutes. Well, it's not completely horrible, but the harmonics were pretty bad. It was around, say I was getting plus 20 dBm out, and the second harmonic was minus 7. Yeah, let's go with minus 7. So minus 27 dBc down on the harmonics, so it would need, what, 10 to be at the bare minimum of minus 36 dB down. And a bit more simple Pi filter might actually be barely enough to bring this into compliance, but in reality I'd really need to rebuild the whole thing. And if I'd go that road, I might as well build something other thing, some other thing, like say Peter Parker's VK something YE's simple transmitters, especially the one he built for 10 megahertz band, 30 meters, because I have a pile of 10.111 crystals and it would be neat to build a transmitter there, and maybe also add like a real low pass filter with the R-core transformer so that the parts are easy to get and make it actually compliant, and also because it's above 1 megahertz, 10 megahertz, then I can actually see it on my spectrum analyzer here. So that would also be nice. But yeah, this was Ocean Henry 2, Foxtrot Tango Golf. Don't forget to like and subscribe so that you don't miss my other quick experiments and tear down some builds and microwave stuff, fiddling with old microwave gear and new to me gear and so on. Also, click the bell so you don't miss anything when I release more of this QRB fiddling.